Time for round three. Unfortunately, we're on the play, though. This is actually probably a better hand on the play than on the draw, since I've got enough lands and I've got things to play. So, we'll proceed from here. Got random flyers. Got a few too many land, probably, but that'll probably even itself out. So far, I've been drawing pretty well with this deck, I've got to admit. Plains, Ichor-Klamir. Not exactly the start I would have predicted. Let's go play our very powerful Trinket Mage. One of our first picks, actually. Which is Trinket Mage for Horizon Spellbomb being your first pick is not usually the best thing to have happen to you. Alright, well, can't really justify chumping here. Especially since who knows if he's actually poison. Who knows what he's doing. Serum Raker, on the other hand, I will block with given the opportunity. Might as well bash in for some damage whilst I'm at it. Alright, mono white poison. Yeah, let's block. His guy essentially hits for 4, mine only hits for 3, so blocking seems good. Plus, I've got a handful of garbage, as apparently does he. Yep, white green poison. You, Blight Widow. That's gonna be rough. Not exactly sure what I'm gonna do about that. I guess I could chump or something. Yeah, I'll play this. I mean, again, might draw the Flame Fiend, which I've actually never sacked Rise and Spellbomb to, though I keep hoping to every single game. So he's pretty flooded, it looks like. Well, I mean, I guess as flooded as me. He's got at least 6 lands. Yeah, we're gonna take it. Can't kill this guy. I don't really want to chump yet. Alright, unlike last time, I'm going to remember to attack before casting my artifacts. Did Dispense Justice? Oh, Master's Call. I guess I didn't predict that, but I'm fine with trading 2 guys for a Trinket Mage. Does he even want to do that? And once again, someone has made an action without really thinking about why he's doing it. Alright, I guess we'll untap this guy. Alright, so hopefully we get to block his Blight Widow with our Lumengrid Gargoyle. He doesn't have any tricks or anything. But yes, much like last round, who the Master's Call pre-comp or mid-combat, then not blocking, just like the Mirror Propagator and not blocking. 5 mana. Really have no idea what to expect. Oh, Banishment Decree? Alright. Well, we're, I believe, chumping here. Nah, we'll go to 8. Why not? He doesn't have a ton of poison guys, and I would like to untap one of my guys. Yeah, I'll still trade my Trinket Mage for both his tokens if he wants. Alright, I think if I'm going to chump, I'd actually rather chump with Trinket Mage, so hopefully does not have another removal spell. I mean, if he had like a Shatter Revoke, maybe, yeah, no, I would have probably Banishment Decree first because this guy costs so much mana. 6 mana. Victory's Herald. Alright. I could have gone for a Control Magic there, that's for sure. Untapping the Mirren Spy. Attacking seems pretty poor here because if I attack with Lumengrid Gargoyle, he can block with Blight Widow, then he gets to attack for free with his Victory's Herald without fear of me doing anything. Feels like I should have a Forest in this deck because I always have the Spell Bomb in play. I guess I've got 2 in my deck, counting Trinket Mage. So now when he attacks with everything, well, it looks like he's arresting. Oh, no. I was going to say block Victory's Herald with Lumengrid Gargoyle and chump Blight Widow with Mirren Spy, but looks like I'm not getting the opportunity. Alright, that was me rubbing my hands together in anticipation of drawing a Cerebral Eruption that hits for 4? Ooh, a Volition Reigns. That is certainly not something I'm going to complain about. Yep, definitely taking Victory's Herald here. Yoink. I'm not sorry to have drawn that. The question is now if I want to hit with Lumengrid Gargoyle. If I hit with Gargoyle, that looks pretty good to me. I'll leave all my other rest of the guys back, because they can't attack into Blight Widow. Alright. So, let's see. Next turn, assuming he blocks Victor's Herald, he takes 7, 8, 9, 10. Well, I have exactly lethal if he doesn't do anything. Hopefully this Volition Reigns was enough. Well, so if I attack with everything and he has anything, then I die. If he had anything, what could he have that he would not have played? He can't have like, he could have like a Divine Offering or something like that. I think there's no real reason to get like super greedy. Let's just attack with those bad boys. This leaves me enough blockers if he has a trick. And if he doesn't have a trick, it puts him in a pretty tough spot. Because either he chumps with Blight Widow and goes to, I guess, 10 after chumping. Or he goes to 3. And I still have a flying blocker in case he has, like, a Bladed Pinions or something. Alright, so he does not have anything, I do not think. But if he had anything at all, I would have lost there. And it looks like I'm winning pretty handily, because if he has nothing, then I'm still going to win in a turn. And there aren't that many cards he could draw that really wreck me here. I mean, he's got a lethal guy in play, a Cyst Bearer, but there aren't that many ways to get him through. Alright, he's going to bash, I'm sure. And the question now is, what do I want to block with? I think I'm just going to block with the Peace Strider. I'll let him gain a life, because if getting Cyst Bearer off the board makes it a lot less likely that he can just kill me out of nowhere. Certainly don't want to just chump with Silvermere and die to the +1/+1 and trample card. Unnatural Predation. Alright, that's going to be good, because I can untap a guy post-combat, so if I do this, I hit him for 7. Yeah. Seems pretty good. And then post-combat, Brassy, untapping, Lumengrid Gargoyle. Now I've got I got GG'd, so hopefully that means, yes, that means I am not dead. Alright, Peel to Volition Reigns, so I can't complain about that. So he's got a bunch of sweet poison guys. I guess Bonds of Quicksilver could be decent here. Take out this crappy Riddlesmith, which I probably shouldn't have been playing to begin with. Crush. So far, I just saw Silvok Lifestaff. I don't think that's quite enough to get me to board it in. Spire Serpent might be a better blocker than something like Brass Squire, which did not successfully block any of his guys. And I guess that looks pretty good for me.